Hi Pisces, it's Sloane Rhodes here with your mid-September through mid-October love and romance reading 2016. I know you've had to wait a long time for your reading, and I appreciate your patience. I'm going to be drawing one card from the Romance Angels Oracle deck for you, Pisces, and it's going to be looking at the overarching energies for you during this time period. Three cards from the Fairy Tarot and one card from the Tarot of Sexual Magic in the area of physical and sexual intimacy. I have already shuffled all the decks, Pisces, and I'm just going to go ahead and shuffle a bit more and pull the cards and get started with your reading. It's for mid-September through mid-October, and as you know, Pisces, these energies will be around before this reading, as well as lingering for a little bit of time as well after the reading, after this time frame. Pisces. Okay. Calling in your soulmate. Your prayers, affirmations, and visualizations help bring you together. A lot of meanings in there, so let me go ahead and get all the cards drawn, Pisces, and then we'll go ahead and do your reading here. Okay, one card just dropped out. So the Four of Winter dropped out, Seven of Summer flipped up, and let me get one more for you. Okay. And the World, Major Arcana card. Okay. I'll show you the cards as I see them, Pisces. We have the Four of Winter, the Seven of Summer, and the World. Let me get one more card for you, Pisces, from the Tarot of Sexual Magic, as I just take in these energies for you. Okay. The Knave of Chalices popped up. Okay. Well, it's really interesting, Pisces, because, all right, so we have this calling in your soulmate card, right? So for some of you, you may already be with your soulmate, but it's not about trying to find a new soulmate. It's about deepening your connection with your soulmate, so keeping your thoughts and vibrations and frequency high in terms of your energy, in terms of your thoughts and actions and all that. So that takes care of you guys. and then for some of you, you may feel that you're not with your soulmate, and you desperately are seeking that that connection where you feel like you are with your soulmate, right? And so this card is a beautiful reminder that you are already at one with your soulmate. It came in so strongly because as I'm looking at this card, I'm like, whose hands are those? Are those his hands or her hands? And so I've never looked at the card like that before. I've never thought of it. So the reason it came through like that for me, for you Pisces right now, is to so that I can convey the message to you that you are already one, that you are missing nothing, and that this idea that your soulmate will bring you something that you lack is an illusion, and that you already have everything you already have everything inside of you already. The soulmate will reflect more of that to you as you keep your vibrations high. But when you are going through your prayers, your affirmations, your visualizations from a place where you feel lack, as if you are seeking something outside of yourself to make you feel whole, this is a gentle reminder, and you know this already, I'm just reminding you, this is a gentle reminder that you are missing nothing, and your soulmate won't bring you those energies, won't bring you those feelings. Those feelings already exist within you, and that your soulmate will reflect them back to you. It's a really beautiful reminder for you, and it's coming in such a funny way. And so it's just kind of another way of your guides and angels letting me know that you are, you'll benefit from having a little bit of humor about this, because I'm getting a lot of winky and humor energy with this as it comes in for you. So I hope you got that in the way that it was meant to be conveyed. Let me move on. I can always go back to that. Okay. So then we have so we have this four of winter, we have the seven of summer in the world. I'll show you one more time. And the four of winter is a card of rest. It's a card of spiritual integration. And let's talk about the four of winter first, because it's coming up very strongly for me. It's very important for you. So as you are calling in your soulmate, right? As you are spending time visualizing time together, visualizing what this person will be like in your life, and you are beginning to understand, as I've already mentioned, because I'm reminding you, that this person is not going to bring you anything different than what you already have within, right? It will reflect it more and more as you begin to know that you are whole and complete already within, right? And I feel like this four of winter energy, this kind of timeout energy, is in order for you to begin to understand that more and more within yourself. I think that there has been a connection for some of you that has always been like, why is this person like this? Why is this person in my life? Why are they show up? And it's like almost like a magnetic attraction with someone. And you may have a soul's connection with them, but you're not necessarily together. And the reason I say that is because with this Knave of Chalices card, it often comes up for me when couples aren't necessarily together and there's quite a bit of jealous imaginings going on. Like, here this guy is. He's trying to convey his emotions in this letter, but he's not able to do it right because his connection just doesn't seem to make sense, right? It's not logical because it's a soul's connection, but he's imagining his beloved, his soulmate, we'll say here, with another, and it's making him kind of crazy here. And again, it's you know, they're under the moonlight, so it's, and there's a black cat, so there's a sense of magic between the connection, but all this frustration because not everything is revealed yet. Not everything is as it seems, and so that's kind of like what this is about for some of you. For some of you, it's like there's that person that you have that connection with, and you're like, why? You know, this person's so different than anyone I would normally be with. I don't really even know this person, but yet we have this intense seeming bond, but we're not together. And I think this four of winter is kind of more about you having some time to reflect on the connection, on what you want. Even if you haven't connected with someone as I'm speaking, there may be an energetic connection with someone that you have not yet met in the physical, and you're just feeling it in a physical way, and it's made you tired, and you kind of want to take a little rest, right? And then the Seven of Summer, kind of going with this Knave of Chalices energy, is about confusion, right? You know, the Seven of, you know, he's confused. He doesn't understand what's going on. He can't communicate in the way that he wants to, and he's imagining all these things happening, in with his beloved. And then the Seven of Summer is like all this kind of crazy energy. Like, I don't know which way to go. I can't make a decision. And it kind of makes sense, with this as well, because that's kind of timeout energy. And then I think you're kind of fatigued because this is also going on simultaneously. It's like too many options, too many things going on, and then you may even drink too much during this time period because you're confused, and it kind of goes with this. Like, I feel like he's drinking too much. He's just adding to the frustration here. And so the Seven of Summer is a lot of confusion, right? And that's okay. You know, it's okay to be confused sometimes. But what's important is to go ahead and take action. And if you are just going back and forth, 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 and making yourself crazy with that kind of cyclical thoughts, really what this card is letting you know is that there is power in making a decision. There is power in taking a stance, moving forward, and that you can never do it wrong. You know, you cannot, from a soul's perspective, you can never do it wrong. So just, I hope that you can find some comfort in that, because a lot of times we beat ourselves up like, oh, well, what if I make the wrong choice? You make the choices you make for a reason, right? And you co-create situations for a reason. And so as long as you can kind of give yourself a little bit of distance so that you see yourself kind of more from a distance, as if you are up in a tall tree looking down upon yourself, and you see this person you know, maybe climbing, and they're really worried they're never going to reach the top. But you can see very clearly there's a search party coming up, where there's, you know, a river with a boat, or, you know, this kind of thing. So it's kind of like that perspective, you know, because this is very much about your angels being beside you and knowing that you are one with your angels. You know, a lot of people often will say, oh, you know, who are my guides and angels and everything. But remember that you are, you know, are part of your guidance system. The expanded you is part of your guidance system. The future you, so to speak, is part of your guidance system. So you're kind of clumped in there with your guides and angels as one. You're also one guidance system. So I don't know where that just came from for you Pisces, but it seemed important because I said it. All right. And then we have the world energy, right? This is beautiful fullness energy. The end of a cycle, something which I really am hoping is this kind of cycle of you know, being so tired and all this confusion, and the world energy is about, it's a major arcana energy, so it's a beautiful expression of the completion that you will begin to feel at the end of this time period, right, towards the end of this time period. It's about fullness, full understanding, making a decision. The end of the cycle of confusion and fatigue. You're free to go in any. I'll read you the text of the card, Pisces. It says, "A brilliant success, the freedom to go in any direction, a journey that is now complete." And it is that sense of fullness that you will experience here as you kind of move forward into October and beyond. It's a beautiful energy for you. It is a major arcana card, so it's a more more expanded energetic pattern that's occurring during this time period. Okay, let me get, what time are we? Okay, 11:44. Let me get some additional cards for you, Pisces, on this calling in your soulmate. Ace of Spring. Oh, I think it was Aquarius that just got this beautiful new beginning. Six of Spring. Beautiful, beautiful card. More fire energy of victory. Wonderful news. And the Balance card, which is about integration, which goes very much with this card here. So it looks like as you keep your vibration high, your frequency high, your thoughts positive, praying and visualizing and saying your affirmations from a place where you already feel full, where you don't feel as if you're lacking something, that someone's going to give you something that you don't already have. The more that you can kind of begin to do that more and more, it's very strong, powerful energy for you. It brings in this beautiful new beginning, beautiful new passion and creativity, the opportunity to be victorious, right, in love, to be in the spotlight in love, possibly with your soulmate, right, regardless of whether you're coupled or single. And then we have the Balance card, again, this card of integration and a card of change, which goes with that, the fullness of the world, the Ace, new beginnings, and which creates change, right? And the change is about more and more understanding that nothing is, that you're not incomplete, that you're not in need of something else to fulfill you, that you have everything you need in you already. You're a beautiful, wonderful, whole human being. You're a soul, you're a spark of the divine, right? And so the illusion that someone else has something that you don't have, that will bring you something that you don't already have, is just that, it's an illusion. And I feel like the Balance card is about you beginning to integrate that more, to play with those energies of am I whole or am I half? You know, a lot of times many people experience this on the planet Earth, that sense that you are missing something, that sense of being incomplete, and that another will make you whole. But you know that two wholes make a whole, right? It's not half and half. It's like you have to be whole to really experience that wholeness, right? And that's what you're kind of working on during this time period. Again, it's a relatively short period of time that you're working on this, but these energies are going to be at play for you prior to this reading and extending beyond, because we've got some major arcana energies here, and so they tend to be energetic patterns that play out in a grander way within your life. And the balance card is very important for you as this, you have this period of integration. So allow yourself time to rest and relax and be gentle and kind with yourself during this time period, because the balance card is also about taking your time. I'll read you the text of the card, Pisces. It says, take everyone's viewpoint into consideration or input. Merge viewpoints to create a better solution, including that of your lover or boyfriend, girlfriend, spouse. And take your time. There's no need to rush. This is not a time to rush through any of this, Pisces. You're going to be victorious. We have the Six of Spring here. We have this beautiful new beginning, so just rest and relax. Make a decision when you can to help move you along here. And just know that you're working on some beautiful, big patterns right now. Let me go ahead and get one more card from the Oracle deck. Which one do I want to get for you? Let's do the Fairies. Let me do the Life Changes Oracle deck for you, Pisces, as you are working on some new beginnings here, a sense of completion with the world. You know, I mentioned the kind of the jealousy of this card for you, Pisces. It's important to allow yourself a little bit of... what's the word I'm looking for? The opposite of clarity. Allow yourself a little bit of time to for the way to be illuminated for you right now, because this is this energy is transient. It's moving, and so try not to latch on too much to this energy down here in the area of physical and sexual intimacy. This idea of imagining your darkest thoughts coming to fruition. It's kind of the opposite of this energy, right? This calling in your soulmate from a very, very high place as opposed to a place of need and want. And this is kind of the opposite of that here. So, all right. Leaving. Interesting. Well, it does make sense that you are leaving an old way behind, because we have this is the end of a cycle. So you're, whatever that means for you, you know, it could be for some of you you're leaving a marriage. For some of you, you are leaving an old pattern of behavior behind of where you are not in alignment with who you feel yourself to be, because we're always changing and transforming. It's going to be different for everybody. It is a general reading, but I really do feel it goes beautifully with this balance card, this idea of the, you know, integration, right? And this card, the Four of Winter, as you take time out to integrate. I'm drawn to the black and white here as integrating polarities within yourself, the adult, the grown-up adult person with the inner child, the divine masculine with the divine feminine, the, you know, all of that coming into play here as you begin to leave old patterns behind where you felt less than, where you felt that you weren't whole and complete. It's a process, Pisces, so be gentle and kind with yourself. It doesn't happen overnight for most people. And but know that you are leaving something behind because you're going deeper into your heart. Oh, it's so lovely as I feel it for you. You're going much more deeply into your heart space, where you know, your heart is who you are. Your mind, your ego is what you use, right? And your mind and your ego are at play down here. But your heart knows already that you're whole and complete. And I think that's what you're beginning to integrate more, you know, and balance, create more balance with. I mean, our ego is always with us. It's never going to go away. But you can just kind of begin to master those energies more. When they come in, you can recognize them and master them, and you can say, oh, there you are, ego. I see you've come for me again. Well, thank you, but I'm going to go back to my heart. You know, let me begin from within. Let me start with my heart. And you go right back to your heart. So I hope you find that helpful, Pisces. I wish you much love as always, and I will see you on the next video or it's your private reading. Till then.